I'm Ellie Setback, reporting.
Thank you very much. Steven, considering Showtime's going to control the production, is Mauro going to call this fight? Who's going to be on the call?
You know, we are controlling production, but this is very much a collaboration. Obviously Mauro's our go-to guy and has a history in both boxing and MMA. But we're going to sit down with both Dana and his colleagues as well as Leonard and put together a team that makes the most sense for the good of the event.
Dana, would you like to see some UFC announcer representation on the call?
I don't know. We haven't really got into that yet. Like Steven said, we're going to talk about it and we'll figure it out. I don't have a problem. Listen, at the end of the day, Showtime put up a lot of money, to get Floyd Mayweather over there and to promote his fights and whatever they want to do. They've been very, very, very fair in this negotiation and letting us do things that they absolutely did not have to let us do. So I'm cool with anything.
Danny, you're looking forward to doing, from what I'm reading from Steven there, an afternoon UFC card the same day as the event. Is that what you're thinking?
No, there will be no UFC that day. This is a boxing day.
Okay, great. Danny, to what degree would you expect Conor to kind of frame this up in the interviews ahead of time? Is, MMA being a superior fighting sport to boxing, kind of framing it as MMA are real fighters and boxers are just boxers. Do you expect him to put it that way?
The reality is MMA is MMA and boxing is boxing. And he's stepping into the boxing arena. It doesn't matter if they fought out in the street, what would happen. He has agreed to come in and box Floyd Mayweather. So it is what it is.
I don't want to get too sidetracked on this, but, I think the best analogy to use here is it's NASCAR and Formula One. NASCAR's not going to replace Formula One. Formula One's not going to replace NASCAR. You see some crossover, a driver from Formula One will try NASCAR. No one makes a big deal about it. They say, that'll be interesting to see how the skills transfer. I think that's what we're talking about here.
Great. And
Floyd Mayweather and Conor McGregor are such unique individuals. And so dominant in both of their sports and in every way, shape, and form. It's a fun fight, And like Leonard said earlier, this isn't some fight that we went out and tried to make or build or anything else. This thing built itself. This is a fight that started from the ground up. The fans wanted to see this thing. The media went crazy about it. And here we are.
Finally for Leonard. Leonard, when did Conor first get on Floyd's radar? Was there a fight he won or an appearance he made that made this all of a sudden start to be a real thing?
Well, I can't exactly remember the time frame, but the kid, he's been making a lot of noise, and I had watched the fight or something, and I was telling Floyd, this kid got a nice hand game. And Floyd thought, he said, he do got a nice hand game. So, again, this is a fight that Floyd is taking very, very seriously, because we all do know all it takes in boxing is one shot, and it don't have to be a clean shot. A guy with that kind of power, he can nick you, and you can be buzzed. There's been a few times in fights in Floyd's career that, he might have been buzzed in a fight, but nobody never knew. And there's been a couple times that he's been buzzed in a fight. So the one thing about Conor McGregor we do know is that you got to pay him very, very close attention, because when he touches people, they fall out.
Thanks, guys.
Our next question comes from Brian Campbell with CBS Sports.
Hi, Dana. You made a pretty large 180 in terms of not supporting this fight originally, saying it would be an epic fail for Conor if he went down this road, and then supporting it. So how much of that had to do with the idea of this being financially beneficial for the UFC to pay off debt after the sale last year?
I didn't say that this would be an epic fail for Conor to go down this path. That was something else that I was talking about. What was the question about the debt?
How much does this have to do with the UFC receiving money to allow this fight to take place?
Listen, if you're going to ask me stupid questions, at least get your questions right. First of all, I didn't say that this would be an epic fail if he went down that path. And we were talking about something. something else because Connor and I were actually butting heads on something. That's when I said that would be an epic fail if he went down that path. Number two, as far as the debt goes, Connor could fight twice this year, and we're going to do fine anyway. This is a fight that Connor wanted, Mayweather wanted it, and the fans wanted it. So we're doing it. So if you can ask me a stupid question, at least get it right.
Sorry, I meant epic fall, not epic fail. But, Leonard, from your point of view, Dana had said this would be at fight contested at 154 pounds. What went into that decision for Floyd?
We had no issues with fighting Conor McGregor at 154. It's a fight that's going to take place at 154 pounds.
What were the biggest points of contention in the negotiation for anyone?
There really weren't any. This was actually really smooth.
It's one of the smoothest that I've ever been involved in.
Me too.
So, there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekpak, reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter, at Sekpak. And you can follow me on Instagram, at Ellie Sekpak.